Mark Walker catches up again with our local GP, Emma Sloan, to discuss another important health issue amongst men.
So with Christian Morton and I'm with Emma, Dr. Emma Sloan again from Sloan Clinics. I'm going to be talking about erectile dysfunction. So probably a first for latest news, but what's the story behind that? Is it quite common amongst men? Emma, maybe if you start off with you, and how can you treat it?
Okay, so I think it is an important topic to talk about. And I think that men, in general, find it really hard to talk about anything to do with their health and health matters. And actually, as a GP, quite often I have men being sort of encouraged to go to see their doctor by their wives or loved ones. It isn't sort of inherent in them to go and seek help for things. So first of all, I would say that if any of your male viewers do suffer with erectile dysfunction, really do go and see your GP, because we're very adept at managing the embarrassment for people. We're very understanding that it's a difficult thing to come and talk about with us, and we accommodate that by being very sympathetic. Men with erectile dysfunction is very, very common, actually, and especially as we get older.
Why is that? What happens then in the body?
Okay, so a couple of things. First of all, your erections are fueled by blood flow.
Yes, yeah.
They're also fueled by a psychological element too. And you need the both in order to have an erection. Now, as we get older, our cardiovascular system doesn't work as well. And so people can actually experience it just through pure lack of or reduced blood flow to the penis. So it's very important that you go and see your GP if you're experiencing this, because it could be an indication that your cardiovascular system is in need of checking.
So what help can you give to a patient then, Christian?
Well, firstly, it's about support. You know, knowing there's somebody to talk to, because this is a very serious subject, you know. We're all used to growing up smiling when anybody says erectile dysfunction. But it's a very serious subject and it wrecks lives.
Yeah.
It can wreck relationships within weeks, because obviously your partner's thinking, am I not attractive enough? So there's lots of different drivers there and things can fall apart very quickly.
Yeah.
Okay. So what we do, we have a chat. We find out what's going on the outside. You know, are there things in life at the moment that, you know, making this happen, or we then go to hypnosis and the subconscious can tell us exactly what is going on.
Thanks for coming in, Emma and Christian. Thanks.
Thank you.